Canberra United are the most unpredictable team in the competition. The most goals scored per game, but the most conceded as well. What will the team in green produce in front of home fans today? Hello and welcome to McKellar Park in Canberra, where Canberra United are taking on the Central Coast Mariners. On paper, this is 12th v 10th, but both teams have plenty of excitement in store. As always in the dub, it's very difficult to predict. With me on commentary today is Western Sydney Wanderers legend and former Matilda, Catherine Canulli. Kath, what are you expecting from this game today?
I think we're going to be in for a cracking game this afternoon. I think both of these teams have got plenty to play for. We're looking at 10th v 12th, but it doesn't show their performances across the season. Canberra United, we know, have got plenty of fire up front, and Central Coast Mariners are structurally have been set up very, very well. So I'm sure we're going to be in for a cracker this afternoon.
Well, let's take a look at the way the teams line up this afternoon. Canberra United, three changes to the team that lost against Melbourne Victory last week. 24-year-old Coco Mastorovic makes her first start in the Liberty A-League after Chloe Lincoln's red card last week. American Sarah Clark replaces Alex McKenzie in defence, and young Kiwi Ruby Nathan starts in place of Ava Piazza, who picked up a little niggle during the week. Chilean international Maria Rojas returns from injury via the bench. For the Central Coast Mariners, no changes to the starting 11 for the team that really impressed in the draw against Melbourne City last week. Sarah Langman once again starts as keeper, with Casey Dumont relegated to the bench. The only change is on the bench, where Mexican youth international Brianna Woodall has been dropped and replaced by academy product Annalise Rasmussen. Well, Kath, there's one player, really, who's grabbed all the headlines for Canberra this season.
We can't go past Vesna Milivojevic. She's been fantastic this season. I think she's been a key product of this Canberra United team. Whenever she goes forward, she's just so unpredictable. The way she links the midfielders to attack, and whenever she goes forward, you just get excited for Canberra United, and that's been a key part of their season this year.
Of course, Milivojevic looking to add to her 8 goals this season. For the Mariners, who do you think is the key player for them?
Bianca Galich, I think, has been having a fantastic season. We know she's coming back from that ACL injury that made her miss out on last season. She's a great person on and off the field. She's a great leader. The way she just leads this Central Coast Mariners team around, and the way she dictates her football knowledge, and the way she has the technical ability to be able to pick out passes and break those lines, I think is fantastic. And I think she's been highly underrated this season already.
Well, the referees today, the central official is Isabella Livery. She's assisted by Lauren Hargrave and Delphina Shakespeare. The fourth official today is Nathan Shakespeare. The team's now in their huddles preparing to come out onto the pitch for this clash. Michelle Heyman, well, she knows all about the Central Coast Mariners. She actually won the first ever Julie Dolan medal back in 2009, scoring 11 goals in 11 games for the Mariners.
Michelle Heyman's been a fantastic stalwart for this competition, and I'm sure today there'll be a little bit of a piece of her heart being pulled, obviously playing against the Central Coast Mariners. It was where her career began, and, you know, she was just a young 17, 18-year-old that kicked off in the W League back then, and it's fantastic to see her playing and doing so well in the Liberty A League.
Not many players left in the league who played for the Mariners back in the day. Here's certainly not one of them, Jasmine Wardlow. She's been incredibly impressive this season.
She has been. I think she's been a really good pickup for Emily Husband. She's really done her homework on Wardlow. We know that she's played for Fiorentina. She's played for Spartak Subotica, which I'm pretty sure she played with Vesna Milivojevic over in Serbia. So it'll be great to see how she goes today coming up against Vesna.
Well, it'll be the home side ready to kick off. Michelle Heyman, 97 Liberty A-League goals. Will she get closer to that milestone today? The home crowd will certainly be hoping that's the case. Signal given by the referee, and we are underway in Canberra. A long kickoff to get the action underway, and here they go driving into the penalty area. Only a goal kick, but there we go. Early doors, indications of that pace of Canberra. Their speed in transition is how they've scored a lot of their goals this season.
they've been so rapid when they go from defence to attack, and they've got the firepower up front. You can even see with Maria Rojas on the bench as well. She'll bring another, you know, attacking dynamite to this team as well. But going forward, they're just so clinical and just very, very rapid.
Well, the most goals per game in the competition so far, the most goals conceded per game as well, which is probably why they are bottom of the ladder, but an excitement machine. Here's Ruby Nathan, the Kiwi international. We'll play it back to Ilioski, who'll look for a ball. Can't find it though. The ball will trickle out for the first corner of the afternoon.
It's always nerve-wracking in these first 5 minutes of the game. As a coach, you're always telling your team in the first five to make sure that they're switched on, and to give it corner away this early in the match. Central Coast Mariners here have got to really be switched on.
It'll be Young. Stunnish Floody will take the corner. We'll whip it in towards the front post. Well cleared by Wardlow. Milivojevic getting involved. Stunnish Floody delivers again, but well claimed by Langman. And this is Sarah Langman's second start for the Mariners. She has actually displaced Casey Dumont, who is forced to sit on the bench this afternoon.
Fantastic to see Sarah Langman in goals. And for the Central Coast Mariners to have two quality keepers in Dumont and Langman, it just goes to show that it gives competition in that position as well, which a lot of teams generally don't have. And it's sometimes a good headache to have as a coach, to have two number ones.
Both keepers very experienced at this level. Of course, Dumont famously played for Melbourne Victory last season. She saved and scored a penalty in that penalty shootout against Melbourne City. Rola Badawiya, well, she'll be hoping to add to her two goals this season. This afternoon was the NPL New South Wales gold medal winner in 2022 before signing for Sydney FC. Has since signed for the Mariners in search of more game time. Here come the Mariners in attack, but Sasha Grove doing well to cut it out. Flannery dropping into midfield to retain possession. And now Grove. Flannery again. Flannery trying to get through and fouled on her way through by Isabel Gomez. It's in defence, Catherine, that we'll see this structure of the Mariners come to the fore.
Central Coast Mariners have been fantastic with their defensive structure. It's something that Emily Husband has spoken a lot about pre-season, saying that that's something that is her main focus. And you could see that last game against Melbourne City. They had clear roles and responsibility in defence, and that's really what got them something out of that game. And they've been super disciplined. It's about now turning that defensive structure and working their way forward and start to be a bit more unpredictable and starting to show some signs of, you know, combination play in that front third.
Well, here's this pressure from Canberra United. Won the ball high up the pitch. Milivojevic now has it out wide. She'll be looking for options in the middle. She'll deliver off the post and off Heyman, out for a goal kick. Well, Heyman claiming that it came off a Mariners defender last. But a dangerous opportunity for Canberra.
We can just see that's what Vesna brings. She just has so much power behind her. She's always looking to put that ball into dangerous areas. And what a better player than having someone like a Michelle Heyman waiting in the box for a great delivery like that. It was just unlucky that one there didn't actually swing back in behind.
Well, Catherine, I know you're not a goalkeeper, but in that situation, Langman, should she have been covering her front post?
Don't talk to me about goalkeepers and positioning. I just like scoring against them, to be honest. But in that situation, I think Langman would have been a little bit caught off guard as well in the way, you know, Vesna was trying to cross that ball. It just sort of come off her foot and she sort of just mishit that as well.
Well, it's the Mariners who had possession in Canberra's third before it was taken away from them. And Christofferson off and away on that far side. Here come Canberra again. Milivojevic plays it back. Looking for options on that side. But defended well by the Mariners. They're not an easy team to score past. They've only scored 6 goals this season, the Mariners, but they haven't conceded many either, only 9. So that is that structure of Emily Husband. Here's Michelle Heyman. Does the flag stay down? Flag is up. Ball was in the back of the net from Heyman, but always looked offside.
That was always offside, but a nice little piece of passing practice or shooting practice for Michelle Heyman to get herself warmed up.
Well, it was a good finish. Does that bode well for the rest of the game?
Of course it's a good finish when no one's, you know, coming or chasing after you. You're easy, you're on your own and you're there. And it was a good little finish for Michelle Heyman, and hopefully more goals to come.
She can make it look easy sometimes, Heyman, but Mariners almost with the ball through then. Ugamal is putting pressure on that Canberra defence. Here they come up this far side, but not able to be controlled and out for a throw. Ilioski was very impressive last week. He's ever present. Just unfortunately wasn't able to be impressive in a winning side, of course. Last week, Canberra going down 2-0 to Melbourne Victory, but was named player of the match for Canberra regardless. Very important player for them.
She sure is, and she's a key part of this Canberra side. And you need players that have been in and around the league for a little while, which actually help with that communication and that building of your teams as well. And just a little shaky little 50-50 there between Ugamal and Vesna Milivojevic.
Well, Canberra keeping possession in these early stages. Milivojevic, long ball up the line, searching for the pace of young Kristoffersen. Wasn't able to get there that time.
She's got plenty of it, doesn't she?
Only 19 years of age, 1 goal this season, her first in the league, is Heyman in a battle with Ash Irwin. Irwin gets it away. She's got to be careful today, Ash Irwin. She's on 4 yellow cards for the season, so one more would mean that she's suspended for next week's clash against Perth, the traditional New Year's Eve clash for the Mariners, this time back in the Liberty A-League. And Canberra, they'll win this throw. It's putting a little bit of pressure on, but you often think with Canberra, it's often when they win the ball and can play the ball up the line that is where they are the most dangerous. Well, a free kick here. So an opportunity from a set piece.
They're dangerous from set pieces as well. We know that Vesna has got plenty of, you know, technical qualities to be able to produce a good ball in the box. And then you've got the likes of Flannery and Michelle Heyman, which are very good to get their head on these crosses as well. So Central Coast Mariners have got to be really on their toes here waiting for this.
Vesna Milivojevic to deliver. What can they produce from this set piece? Ball in, punched away by Langman, but it's Sasha Grove on the follow-up. Well, that's a disappointing effort from the youngster.
She just couldn't get her balance there. She's just got to take a better touch there and try and put it back into that box, because especially off those second phase play off corners, you can be super dangerous in those moments.
Absolutely. Players specialise in that second phase play, being able to capitalise, whether that's shooting or putting the ball back in the box. But here come Canberra. Milivojevic looking for options, looking to take a player on as well. It's brought to ground by Badawea. No foul. They're very parochial in Canberra. This crowd not happy about that.
Canberra has got to be one of the worst fields to go and play an A-League match at. It's never a fun place to go, not as a player and not as a coach.
Well, they barrack for their side. We always love to hear that, but on that occasion, Referee Isabella Livery saying that Badawiya did not illegally bring Milivojevic to ground, so it's the Mariners in possession. Irwin looking to play the ball through. Ilioski puts on the afterburners to get there ahead of Paige Haywood. So we'll take a look at this non-foul call again.
Badawiya just squares her up there, right? She just holds her ground, and Beston's trying to pull off the little nutties, and it didn't work for her.
Well, such a technical player, Milivojevic, so good at the ball, with the ball at her feet, able to make things happen. Here's the Mariners looking to make things happen. Ergamal couldn't get there ahead of Clough. And the ball cannons off. Ilioski will be out for a Mariners throw. Throw in is headed away, but now an attempt to get the ball in the middle, just couldn't quite wrap her foot around it, and goalkeeper Mastorovic, of course, in the side today after Chloe Lincoln received a red card last game. It was a denial of an obvious goal-scoring opportunity, nothing malicious in it, but every red card in this competition is an automatic one-game suspension, so the 24-year-old has the opportunity to make her first start of her career in the Liberty A-League.
It also gives her the opportunity to really stamp her mark in this competition and show, you know, Negoš Popović that she's a worthy place of a starter, and it starts to put pressure on, you know, goalkeepers. Unfortunately for this weekend, it's Chloe Lincoln that had the red card from last week, but it gives her the opportunity now to step up and show that she can fight for that number one spot.
Well, hasn't been tested yet. The Mariners looking to do that now. Ergamal. Clough kicks it away. And the Mariners just not able to really get a sight on goal at the moment. Here's Sasha Grove in transition. Look at this pace of Grove. She's got green grass ahead of her. Still going, Sasha Grove now. Izzy Gomez gets back and halts that run. Canberra opts to play back and keep possession rather than trying to force the issue. Heyman, Milivojevic. Kicked away by Irwin and comes off Haywood. It'll be a Canberra throw. Heyman, nice little attempted flick. Appeals for handball, not given. Just attempting to play that through to Milivojevic then, but well defended as it turns out. Kooligan to Ergamal. Ergamal looking to release Haywood, but it was Sarah Clark just giving a taste of what she can do. Her first start today, Clark, the American.
Obviously, Negoš Popović has been searching for, you know, another player to add to his squad, and, you know, knowing that he's had some, you know, defensive issues as well across this team as well over the past, you know, this whole competition, to be honest. But to add her to this squad, I think, adds a little bit of experience as well, but also to bring a player in from America. And, you know, this Canberra United team is quite a young team that really hasn't had much experience in the competition as well.
Of course, it's in America, they have the college system, so players coming into the professional game are 21, 22, 23, as opposed to here, of course, people are debuting at 16, 17, 18. It's those extra few years, not just as a player, but also as a person. They're very important.
Absolutely. We know what the college system can bring, and I remember talking to a lot of the internationals that have come from America, and you always say, what's been the major part in your career? And they talk about college and the professionalism and the way that just sets them up to be a professional as well, which plays a key part in these players' development.
Cannon Clough, an American herself, made her name in the Queensland NPL before playing for Brisbane and most recently the Jets. Long ball for Canberra, able to be swept up rather comfortably by Langman. Taryn King. Long ball looking for Ergamal, who can't quite get there. It's been very good, the Chinese international, since coming in to this side from the province of Inner Mongolia. 27 years of age, has scored in this competition. We're looking to add to that tally today. With two assists as well, shows her importance. Wardlow with the throw to Badawiya, but Sasha Grove just standing up to the challenge, doing well. Here's Heyman. Looking to release Milivojevic. Ash Irwin coming over to cover and does well. And that's what we'll see more of this season from Milivojevic. She will sit high and let Heyman be the one to drop deep and play those balls through.
They both work really, really well together. They've actually formed a really good partnership over the last couple of seasons. You can see previously with Michelle Heyman trying to play those little one touch around the corners in for Vesna Milivojevic. And, you know, there's times where Vesna will come in, drop low, and Heyman will stay a bit higher. But their relationship on the pitch, I think, has been really, really good. And I think both of them, once when going forward, it's always got some sort of either Heyman or Milivojevic involved in it.
Good distribution from Mostorovic. Here's Ruby Nathan looking to just dink it through to Christofferson. Possession stat, it's relatively even at the moment. Of course, 1% margin of error in that stat. But relatively even, both teams just trying to get a handle on the game.
Yeah, you can see it's a quite even game at the moment. Normally the first 10 to 15 minutes, both teams are trying to find their feet within this game. And, you know, once you sort of start to hit the 20, 25-minute mark, you start to see things start to open up. And, you know, teams as well, on the fly and on the pitch, you start to pick up on little things that teams are doing, the way they're pressing, the way they're setting up. And you got to start to make those decisions as footballers and start to think, okay, well, where are the ways that I can start to break these teams down as well? So you'll start to see a bit of that in around the 20 to 25-minute mark.
And he cries of no turn, but the Mariners get it away anyway. Hayward, well, she was looking out wide, couldn't find a teammate. Good defense by Canberra. After their win against Brisbane Roar 2 weeks ago, that 5-1 result, Negos Popovic said that it was like watching his team grow up before his eyes, the defensive discipline, and see if they can show more of that today. Here's the Mariners with a strike from distance off the crossbar from Bianca Galic. So close to the first goal in this game from almost nothing. They're still going here, the Mariners. Badawiya with a ball in over the top and out for a goal kick. Well, how close was that?
That's definitely what Bianca Galic has got in her locker. I remember having her at Western Sydney Wanderers. She'd be scoring pearlers from that distance, and she's such a great technical player around that box. But what a fantastic save that was as well, but Mostorovic.
Fantastic save from the keeper. She's from Brisbane originally, spent 2023 at Bayside United in the NPL Victoria. Had one appearance previously for Melbourne City in the competition, two off the bench for Canberra, and now her first start today. Heyman. Crossing in, Vojvic not able to control the ball. And so it'll be out for a throw.
That's got to give Mostorovic as well plenty of confidence to be able to come up and pull off a save like that from Bianca Galic. I think that will help her grow into this game as well.
Well, it was created almost out of thin air, and that's what quality players can do. Here's Heyman looking to get on the end of it, but Faye Bryson clears it away. We heard Popovich there just telling his players that you can get aggressive, you can get into the game. Just letting them know that, you know, sometimes it takes that extra bit of, you know, not dirty play by any means, but you just need to get into the game a little bit more, be a bit more physical.
Absolutely. You've got to win your 50-50 battles. And as coaches, you'll always be talking about that and going out on the pitch. And, you know, it's an 11v11 game. It's a 1v1 battle that you have to win against your opponent. And you can already see that with Sarah Clark. You can see that aggression that she's bringing into this Canberra United side from that defensive line as well, which is fantastic to see. And Canberra United need a little bit more of that.
Here comes Clark. She'll play a long ball, can't find a teammate, but Milivojevic comes away with it. Still going, Vesna Milivojevic into the penalty area. Well, looked to square it, couldn't do so, tried to keep it in. The ball's trickled out for a goal kick.
Just ran away from her just a little bit too much there, but, you know, the way she's just dribbled that ball in, I remember playing futsal actually with Vesna as well, and you see plenty of that on the futsal pitch as well, and you can see a lot of her game in futsal that she brings once she gets in, especially into that 18-yard box, the way she runs at defenders 1v1, the confidence that she has when she comes up against any other player is just unbelievable.
Langman's goal kick into the mixer in midfield. Mariners players gone to ground, and Canberra, they've come away with it. Irwin can't quite clear it. So Milivojevic will pick up the ball in a good position. Milivojevic takes the strike from distance. Well, she can produce special moments, Vesna Milivojevic, and that was so close to one there.
Super close, that one. It's just, that's what she's got in her locker. She's just got that confidence. She's that player that's, you know, super unpredictable. She knows what she's doing. She takes her little touch to the side. She just have that half an inch there to take a hit. She sees Sarah Langman. She's a little bit off her line there, and she goes for it. And that's what Vesna's all about.
Well, this season she's scored 8 goals in 6 games. But if you take into account last season as well, she's scored 12 goals in her last 8 games. That is outrageous form.
I thought she had a great season last year as well, but this season I think she's really, really grown into this team with Canberra United, and I think she's really, you know, starting to mature as a player. She's getting that little bit older as well. She's decided to come back from Europe, and she's playing her second season now in the Liberty A-League, but I think she's taken her game to another level this season.
Taryn King with the free kick, not able to hit a target, so Nestorovic is more than happy to just give everyone on the pitch a few seconds to have a breather. Cannon Clough, well, is forced to play through 2 Mariners players who were pressing high, does so successfully. Flannery offloads to Heyman, who plays in Stanich Floody. The 17-year-old driving forward, out wide to Christofferson, into the box, the fear Christofferson, 2 defenders in the way, and then more preventing Heyman from getting a sniff in the box. Now, ball delivered, looking for a player, not able to find her. Mariners now, they'll have their chance in transition. Paige Hayward. And it's slowed down by the Canberra defence getting back. Well, both sides, they're still looking for those real clear-cut chances, but the game beginning to open up.
We can see it's starting to open up. Both teams have had a couple of chances. Not obviously created by any build-up by any means, but, you know, getting into those areas where they can have a crack and have a shot off at goal, which is important. I think it's even more important as well for Central Coast Mariners, knowing that, you know, that having a keeper like Mastorovic in goals today, which obviously is her first start, and you've got to be able to test them.
Here's Milivojevic. I was looking for Flannery at the far post, might still reach her. Ruby Nathan involved as well. Michelle Heyman still on the ball. Milivojevic will shoot from distance. straight into the gloves of Langman. Well, it's Canberra now, maybe slightly in the ascendancy.
Langman's done really well there because that shot from Milivojevic, she couldn't really see what was in front of her. There was a lot of players blocking that, so she's done really well to pick that up as well.
Sarah Clark, she has been very impressive so far. Of course, she's 25 minutes into her first start of the season, so you don't want to be too premature, but looks like she's made quite a substantial difference to that Canberra United defence already.
She's been fantastic today. I think she's been really, really strong, especially winning those, you know, 50-50 duels as well. She's been, you know, talking. You can see the way she's leading. You can just see here in the replay, Michelle Heyman just drops it off, knowing that Vesna's there, looking for that strike on goal. And it's unlucky because either side of Langman there, I reckon it's a goal.
Here come the Mariners. Nice turn from Galich and is brought to ground. Although the referee says not illegally, so it'll be a goal kick. But Bianca Galich has been busy. She's probably looked the most likely outlet for the Mariners so far.
She's always tidy, especially up in that front third, in and around the 18-yard box. She can play little balls in behind. She can come deep and pick the ball up and drop it off. And we know that in and around the 18-yard box, she's not shy of striking the ball as well. It's great to see Bianca Galich playing a little bit higher up the pitch, because generally you normally see her playing as a defensive midfielder as well. But I know that she loves playing higher up in that 10 role.
Of course, Galich, formerly of Canberra United, her first season in the competition in 2020-21, and then Western Sydney Wanderers in 2021-22. Missed last season with an ACL, but has come back this time with a bang, just reminding everyone what she is capable of, the 24-year-old. Sasha Grove on the ball, does the step over, audacious, and a shot from Milivojevic on the edge of the area is blocked away. She's still got the ball though. Milivojevic will play back and recycle possession. They'll come again. Canberra from Clark. She'll play it out wide to Ilioski, to Christofferson. Attempted the 1-2, but the pass fell short. It'll go out for a throw instead. Here come the Mariners. Izzy Gomez. Ball up the line to Ergamal. Still going. Ergamal takes a shot from distance. And a wonderful goal. What a strike from Ergamal. Her second of the season. Well, this game, it's been threatening to give us a stunner. And there is the opener.
What a strike. You can see Ergamal there. She's just looking around. She's trying to see if anyone was coming up to support or looking for a little 1-2. She sees the space in front of her. She takes that extra touch. She looks up, and that's it. She strikes it. And what a strike it was. Picked that one out of the back of the net.
That is outrageous from the Chinese international, right where the Spiders live. A fantastic long-range strike. Well, that certainly will change the game now, because Canberra United, they were looking as if they were coming into the game. But sometimes, as we said, it's those moments of magic that can change things, and that certainly was one.
That's football. You can have all the possession, you can have all the shots at goal, and then all of a sudden, in that one moment, you get that little bit of space. And they gave Ergamal way too much space in and around that box. You always know that once, especially strikers, are starting to approach that 18-yard box, you need to come out of your line and start closing those players down. And what a fantastic strike it was from Ergamal.
Well, here she goes again, the woman of the moment, with the ball taken away by Sasha Grove. And the Mariners, they'll come forward with more intensity, with more confidence. It always gives you a boost when you score a goal, and certainly seeing a teammate produce something like that, you're all going to get a massive burst of energy before halftime.
Absolutely. It's always a great way to start the game and get a goal up, and it gives you that confidence, especially for a team like the Mariners that haven't scored many goals this season as well. And to see Ugamal now put a cracking goal in the back of the net, it's going to give the Mariners a lot of confidence to finish off this first half.
Throw in from Wardlow across the box. Badawiya involved, tries to hook it over to a teammate, and eventually it's back to Mistorovic. Well, Mariners claiming that it might have been a pass back from Clark, but it seemed like she was just trying to get something on it to get it out of the way, so Mistorovic was free to claim. In the picture in picture, what do you reckon, Kath? Was it a back pass?
Oh wow, that was a back pass.
Well, not given by the referee, so play goes on.
That's football, right? Sometimes you see it, sometimes you don't, and I guess it's something that the referee has missed in that moment. And fortunate for Canberra, seeing though Canberra have conceded the most penalties, but they've also been awarded the most penalties as well in this season.
They have, and they're a team that knows how to find the back of the net, so certainly 1-0 down, it won't faze them. They know how to score, and particularly they'll back themselves against the Mariners, but the Mariners so sturdy in defence, considering where they are on the table. It's not been conceding goals that's been the problem, it's probably been scoring, as you can see the possession stats being very even. Ball delivered in, looking for Wardlow, but Hutsuch just getting away from her. Jasmine Wardlow back to Paige Haywood. Haywood can't find Gelich, and it'll be out for a goal kick.
We need to credit Emily Husband and the way that she has set up this Central Coast Mariners team as well. You can see defensively especially that all these players know their roles and their responsibilities.
Here comes Gomez to roll up Badawiya. Well done from Mistorovic to ensure that the ball didn't get away from her in that moment. The Mariners in the ascendancy. They've looked very threatening since scoring.
They have. You can just see that confidence there, and that ball in behind there for Badawiya. She's just got to do a little bit better there, where she can just pull it back and away from the Canberra United goalkeeper.
Christofferson brought to ground, but the foul. Well, we'll just wait to see which way the foul's gone. It's gone the way of the Mariners for a foul in the build-up. Faye Bryson will take.
Bit of shoulder to shoulder there, and I thought the foul would have went the other way. She's just pushed her out of the way.
Well, the referee, Isabella Livery, is in the best position. Bryson will deliver. Shot from Ergamal off the crossbar. So close to her second. She'll go again. Ergamal. Oh, she's been involved in everything. The Chinese international just couldn't quite convert then, but off the crossbar in almost a second.
What another top strike by Ergamal. This one here now with her right foot, she's just getting ahead over the ball and just strikes it right through that ball. And you can just see the technique that she has. You know, she scored her goal with the left foot. She's hitting this one with the right foot. Technically, she's so good.
Well, she's aiming for that corner, isn't she? That was... if that had beaten Mistorovic, that was heading into the same corner that she scored the first goal of the game. Looks like Mistorovic may have gotten a slight touch as well. So she made a few great saves today, the 24-year-old. Looks like that was another one.
She has. She's denied the Mariners a couple of times with some great saves. It's just unfortunate, the Ugamal goal. Sometimes there's some of those strikes that you just cannot get as a goalkeeper. And that goal was one of those goals that there is no chance in any goalkeeper being able to save that.
Well, Nulls, we'll take a look at the replay of this foul, because you've been saying a few of these have been 50-50s.
Well, that one was a little bit of a tougher one. It wasn't shoulder to shoulder, but again, sometimes you just got to let the play flow as well.
And this is a case now, I suppose, of momentum, because the Mariners are the team with momentum, and sometimes in sport and in football, it's that intangible thing. Once you get the wind in your sails, you're doing well. Here's Gallich with the free kick, cleared away by Canberra, delivered in again by Bryson, but harmlessly. Mostorovic will take the goal kick. Well, Clough, the high press has beaten her out here. Ergamal looking to play through Hayward, couldn't find her. That was another dangerous moment for Canberra, struggling to play out from the back now.
Yeah, Cannon Cuff there, just struggling to find someone looking to want to come and get on the ball. And she's had to obviously take a couple of extra touches there, and she gets caught out. And Stanik Floody's done really well there in defence to come back and clean that up as well, just to save a Central Coast Mariners shot there as well.
And of course, those moments, you know, it looks bad on Cannon Clough, but really the cause of that moment is teammates not dropping deep and providing those options.
Absolutely. When you're playing out from the back, you need players that are wanting to come and look to get on the ball as well.
Corner in from Bryson towards the back post. Mariners head on it. Ergamal still with it. Can't find a way through a sea of bodies and out for a goal kick.
Canberra and I have got to be really careful in these moments here. They're giving way too much space to Ergamal, especially off this cross. You can see here, she's just there. She's free. She gets on the ball. She's got time there to be able to bring the ball down. It's lucky she didn't get a great touch.
Well, here's Nikki Flannery in space now for Canberra. She'll square it across for Ruby Nathan. Well, a disappointing end to the counter-attack for Canberra United. Nikki Flannery found herself in space, squared it instead of taking the shot herself, and Ruby Nathan not able to convert. Here's the Mariners now looking to play out from the back themselves. Langman to Taryn King. Is that high press from Canberra. You'll see that get more and more intense as the game goes on and as the score remains how it is. Gallich beating out Grove. Still Bianca Gallich. Grove gets a touch and out for another Mariners corner.
Bianca Gallich there just waiting for someone to come and give a little bit of support. We know that she's not the fastest player, but she was just looking there for someone for a little 1-2. Here on the other end, we've got Flannery as well. You can see she's put a great little ball in there. Just unfortunate there. Couldn't get Canberra United, couldn't get something else on it.
Well, should Nathan have struck that first time?
I think it's a little bit of a hard one. It's a run across your body there, and it's just unfortunate that the run and the pass didn't sort of meet up in the right moment. But it is a tough one. It's hard for Flannery as well.
Corner taken short. Bryson towards the back post. Mostorovic had to palm it away, because that from Bryson was heading into the corner. Another dangerous moment for the Mariners.
You can see here, this is something that they've practiced on the training field. A short corner taken really, really quickly, looking for that back post. And as coaches will always tell you, you might be looking for that back post, but you're looking to score in that back corner as well. And just unlucky there for Bryson, to be honest.
Badawea will take the corner from this side. Delivered in towards the front post this time. Still live. And has to be cleared. Well, there was Canberra defenders all over that ball. But it took them almost too long to clear it. They scrambled it away in the end.
You always got to be on your toes when it comes to corners. You can see here Badawea taking it with her left foot. They're looking to in-swing these balls to be able to put Mastorovic under a lot of pressure there, obviously knowing that this is her first game. The way that they're prepared, their set pieces will be to be able to target Mastorovic in goals as well.
Well, another set piece opportunity now, because young Mary Stanage bloody just fouling Bianca Galic, and it's really been the Galic and Ergamal show so far, both of them so heavily involved for the Mariners. It'll be Galic and Faye Bryson just having a conversation about what they want to do with this free kick. Bryson will deliver. Stanage Floody is there. Can't beat the first player. And now Milivojevic looking to hit Kristoffersen. Look at this pace. Wonderful run from Kristoffersen. But the ball taken away from her by Irwin. There's that pace in transition. We've been harping on about it. Knowles, there's your perfect example of it.
She has got fantastic pace to be able to come from behind to be able to beat Faye Bryson in that situation there. She's done really, really well. It's just unfortunate she couldn't get more on it once she did get into those dangerous areas.
Sasha Grove delivers. Langman has to deal with it and does so.
How good is it here? She's come from 2 metres behind to be able to come past Paige Haywood there. Again, just once she does get her little touch there, she's just got to do better in the position of getting it under control and then be able to beat that player again 1v1. But you'd have to say you're pretty exhausted when you make a run like that and get forward.
Gomez to Ergamal. Ergamal will take a touch. Pass Dilioski. Still going Ergamal, but can't get past Sarah Clark. And will win her side another corner. So 5 corners so far for the Mariners. This will be their 6th. They've been piling on the pressure on set pieces so far, making it very difficult for Mastorovic to deal with. Here's Badawiya to deliver again. Cleared away by Stanage Floody. Badawiya will put another ball into the box. Had to be dealt with and was. B. Clark and Ruby Nathan now will look to hit Kristoffersen. We saw her pace earlier. That back pass almost too shallow, but dealt with in the end. Nathan back to Grove and Canberra, well, almost losing out to Ergamal. Clough just lost her bearings there for a moment, but no harm done in the end, and it's her side on the ball, but not able to make anything happen on that occasion. Switch of play finds Bryson on the outside, but good defending again from Clark, who's really been a standout for Canberra in this first half. Milivojevic looking for Flannery. She does keep it in. Heyman's a target in the middle, if she can find her. Flannery delivers. Well, beats everyone and look for a goal kick, but that's much better from Canberra.
They're starting to get a few opportunities going forward. I think just that final pass or that final ball in that front third, they've just got to be a little bit more clinical once they do get into that front third.
As we approach the half-time break, the sides, well, it was 1 goal to Ergamal, an absolute stunner that separates the two sides as we approach half-time. It's been a pretty even game otherwise, but perhaps the Mariners, since that goal, have been in the ascendancy. Canberra, though, still plenty of opportunities of their own and still plenty to work with in the second half. Still stoppage time to try and equalise as well. 1 minute of stoppages. Ruby Nathan. Out wide to Christofferson, who looked to deliver. It will be deflected off a defender, and Canberra will have the opportunity just before half-time for a corner.
The Baroness here have got to really keep their discipline. We always know just before half-time is a crucial time for any team to be able to switch off in these moments. So it's really important here that they do stay disciplined and they can go into this half with this 1-0 lead.
It'll be Milivojevic to take what you'd imagine will be the last opportunity of the half. Can she hit a target here? One arm in the air. Delivers. Towards the back post. No one there, though, for Canberra. Flannery retains possession. She'll drive into the box. Can't beat Quilligan. They'll retain possession. Can't be too much time left, though. Stanish Floody. Canberra searching for one last chance. Milivojevic, ball taken away by Hayward. Well, she'll be given time to take the throw, Milivojevic. Where are the options for Canberra? Christofferson, Milivojevic, cross, has to be punched away by Langman. And anywhere will do for the Mariners. That is halftime at McKellar Park. And it's the away side, the Central Coast Mariners, who lead thanks to a stunning goal from the Chinese international Ergamal from outside the penalty area. It's been an even game. You get the sense there's still plenty of action left in the second 45. Well, home fans will certainly be hoping they can get something out of this second half. Canberra United have only failed to score once so far this season. I'll be hoping they don't make it a second today. Half-time, it's Canberra United 0, Central Coast Mariners 1. So we'll take a look at the highlights, Kath. An opportunity for stunners at both ends.
Plenty of opportunities, especially for Canberra United and Vesna Milivojevic. That in the first half, she knows where the goal is, and you can see here up the other end with Ergamal, she gets that little bit of space and no Canberra United players shutting her down. She knows where the goal is and she puts it in the back of the net.
Well, that was a fantastic strike, and you have to say, Mistorovic, she made a number of saves in that first half, but she was never stopping that one.
You're never stopping those ones. It's sometimes they're the ones that keep us, that they just can't get to it.
Well, here is another strike from Ergamal. Came so close to doubling the Mariners' lead, and they had a number of opportunities like that throughout the half.
They did. We've seen some from Ergamal, some from Bianca Galic as well, but a fantastic save there by Mastorovic. She's done superb in this first half. Other than that Ergamal goal, I think she's been quality for Canberra United.
Well, Kath, what do the stats tell us about what we saw in that first half?
I think the stats just show that it's been quite an even game, and I think the Central Coast Mariners have been, you know, more fortunate in that front third, and that Ergamal goal is just a freak of a goal. Canberra United have also had their chances as well. You can see there the total shots for Central Coast are 6 and Canberra United 4, but all in all, I think it's quite an even game.
Well, don't go anywhere. We'll be right back after the half-time break. At half-time, it's Canberra United 0, Mariners 1. Well, welcome back to Mackellar Park in Canberra, where it's the Central Coast Mariners currently leading 1-0, thanks to a thunder bastard from Chinese international Ergamal. It was a game that ebbed and flowed in the first half, certainly opportunities for both sides, but central to everything for the Mariners was Ergamal.
Ergamal was fantastic in this build-up to this strike. She knew exactly what she was doing. She was waiting for someone to come and you know, give her a little bit of an option to go forward, but she's seen the space in front of her. It was poor defending there by Canberra United. She's attacked that space, and what a strike it was.
A fantastic celebration as well, inspired by Kylian Mbappe, but she came so close again.
She gets over the top of this one as well with her right foot. She's striked it so well. Her technique, the way she can strike a ball with her lace, that is not an easy technique to do.
Well, a fantastic half from her, and she'll be hoping to add to her tally. Ergamal, it was her second goal of the season since arriving in Australia. The 27-year-old, she's impressed throughout the season. She's got two assists as well, so not just goals, but assists and
impact in build-up play as well.
And I've heard from the Central Coast Mariners team as well. I've heard she's a fantastic teammate. She's been a great addition to this Central Coast Mariners team, and she really brings something different. You know, it's really difficult these days when we are looking at foreign players to bring into the Liberty A-League, that we really need to start looking outside the box to be able to bring players in that actually can, you know, give some sort of addition to our teams. Because if they're not a player that's going to add to that, I think sometimes we're better off bringing in a younger player.
Well, two other players very heavily involved in that first half. Vesna Milivojevic for Canberra United and Bianca Galic for the Mariners. What do those stats tell us about the performance of those two players in the first half?
I think both of these players have had a fantastic game. I think majority of their build-ups and in terms of when they are going forward, it does come through, whether it's been Vesna or Bianca on the ball. And we know that both of them have an eye for goal as well. And, you know, majority of their passes, once they do go to break forward, both of these players have got some sort of hold on their team.
Well, it'll be the Mariners who get us back underway for this second half. They made a substitution at halftime as well. Peter Trimmis came on the pitch for Tess Quilligan. So certainly not resting on their laurels, coach Emily Husband, making sure that they can maintain their lead and possibly add to it as well. Trimmis, such an impressive young player, only 17 years of age. He scored 10 goals for Bulls Academy and the New South Wales NPL this season. Yet to score in the Liberty A-League, but we'll be hoping that today's the day. Gomez, Hayward, Trimmis, her first touch of the ball. Goes back to her again, Ergemal, Gomez, now out wide to Wardlow. She'll look to whip in a ball into the mixer, but well claimed by Mastorovic. Well, the Mariners with early possession in this second half. You wonder what the coaches would have said. Well, there's been a head clash in back play, but play will continue regardless. Ball in, but out for a corner. And we'll go back now for this head clash. It was Faye Bryson for the Mariners, who's still down. Well, I think some of the Mariners players expected play to stop there because it was a head clash. We'll take a look at the incident again.
It was just a bit of a rough one there, wasn't it? I think the referee calls play on and didn't realise how bad it actually was, but both players are up on their feet, which is great to see.
Well, Christofferson almost copped an elbow from Bryson, and then meanwhile, as Bryson went down, she's just copped a knock to the head in some way.
It was just an awkward one in that situation, and both of them have just come up with a bit of a head knock there on either end, and that's great to see both of them back up on their feet.
Well, after all that, it will be Central Coast Mariners corner. They had plenty of those in the first half. We'll be looking to convert in the second. Badawiya drifts in the corner. Mariners head to it, but not able to get the direction that was required. Still on the ball, Izzy Gomez. Lead away by Clough now. Badawiya looking for Galic. Not able to get past the defence. Here's Faye Bryson playing it for Galic. Lovely touch from Galic. The finish, though, not to the same standard. Not able to get past Mastorovic, who delivers quickly.
Galic puts herself in a great position there. It's just unfortunate not on her favoured foot. But once you get into that situation there, you just got to put your foot through it.
Well, Gomez has released Badawiya, who'll square it to the back post. Trimmis couldn't get the connection on a tight angle. But promising signs again for the Mariners.
Mariners have started this second half really well. You can see here with Bianca Galic getting herself into a good little position there in the box. And again, you've got to give credit to Mastorovic. She's taken that well. And She's doing really well in her first start of the season.
Ugamal. Ball played through to Badawiya. Badawiya still going, but excellent defense from Sarah Clark. She's been phenomenal today. The American has proven so yet again. Badawiya trying to get past Christofferson. Christofferson just won't go away. And in the end, concedes the foul, much to the dismay of the crowd.
Like I said, you don't want to go against the Canberra United crowd. They're one of the toughest crowds that you got to go up against. I think this is a little bit of a tough call against Christofferson.
Well, certainly she's the smaller player in that exchange. It's quite difficult for her to knock Badawiya over. But anyway, that was the decision. So it'll be Gallage to stand over the free kick. Gallage into the mixer. Good keeping again from the stove. She's been busy. She's been good so far, the 24-year-old. Stanage Floody. Bringing out wide to Christofferson. Sophia Christofferson, drop of the shoulder, gets past Gallage. Squares it and appeals for handball, but not given, only half-hearted. The header back into the box, cleared away. And Canberra United end up with the throw. Well, that was a bit of payback by Christofferson, attempting to get around Gallage. Milivojevic. Delivered in, headed away by Taryn King. Had to as well because Heyman was right there. Sasha Grove now. Attempting to find Flannery, can't do so. Paige Hayward bundled over, legally says the referee, but the Mariners retain the ball in any case. Well, Canberra now, you wonder what Coach Negros Popovic would have told them at halftime, whether there are any minor tweaks or whether it's just a matter of doing what they're doing. Of course, only a one-goal difference in the game, and that goal was something that was very difficult to prevent. It was a stunning goal from outside the penalty area. Maybe could have put more pressure on Ugamal, but nonetheless, Kath, what do you think that would have been the primary message from Popovic at halftime? Well, we'll hold that thought because Ugamal in the middle, but a heavy touch just got away from her and into the gloves of Mistorovic.
I think one of the key messages that he would have had for them at halftime is, especially when they are playing out from the back, that there are players that are wanting to come and get on the ball. And once they do get the ball and move that ball forward and they do start to get into that front third, that they are a little bit more clinical as well. You can see at times when Vesna Milivojevic does get on the ball that, you know, they sort of are waiting to see what she can do with it and sort of let her go on her own, where you need to be looking for that combination play, especially in the front third, or when you are getting crosses in the box, like what type of runs are you making? Where is the second phase of those balls as well?
Well, there was an example of some combination play. Didn't quite come off, but some nice passes in midfield for Canberra, and that's what Catherine Canoe is talking about. But this time, Canberra United have won the foul. Izzy Gomez, just a tug on Michelle Heyman.
She knew in that instance you can't let Michelle Heyman get away from you there, and she just breaks down that part of that play. And we know that Canberra United have got plenty of strike force up front and plenty of players that can score a goal. It was a nice little professional foul there from Izzy Gomez.
She tried to play innocent, didn't she? Hands up in the air, wasn't me, ref, but in that case a pretty clear foul.
Quite clear to me.
Well, it's Sarah Clark on set piece duties on this occasion. Made two appearances for North Carolina Courage in the Challenge Cup in pre-season. Here she is for Canberra. Delivers the free kick. Header away by the Mariners and they'll concede a corner as a result. Well, Canberra, they'll be looking to make use with this set piece. 17-year-old Stanage Floody on corner duties for them on that side. She delivers towards the front post. Langman does well to claim. Now this is this quick release. Gallage up the line. Neat little 1-2. Still Gallage looking for Trimis. Peter Trimis, flag stays down. But can't find an option, the youngster. Still Mariners though. Paige Haywood out wide to absolutely no one. And it'll be a Canberra throw.
That's a tough one for the Mariners. You can see Bryson just throwing her hands up in the air with that pass from Haywood. She's just not aware of what's around her and unfortunately just gives away possession there.
Well, everyone stopped. It was a phantom player in that position. But anyway, the Mariners now with the ball again. Langman happy to make Milivojevic run at her and just wind down a few more seconds.
Langman showing her experience there, a little bit of game management as well, just trying to put a bit of a hold on the game and, you know, really disrupt Canberra.
Well, not great distribution on that occasion, but just about gets away with it. Gomez to Gallage. Played out wide to Ergamal. Ergamal looking for the overlapping run of Bryson. Faye Bryson, though, can't beat Sarah Clark. And out for a Mariners throw. Bryson throw. Nice touch from Gomez. Ergamal now. Nice pass from Ergamal. Roller Badawiya. Now Peter Trimis. Good save and a shot again on the rebound from Wardlow. But palmed away. It was offside on any occasion. But Coco Mostorovic standing tall once again.
Mariners are super unlucky not to get something out of that little Ergamal little pass into Badawiya. And again, Peter Trimis there nearly could have got her first Liberty A-League goal. And just unfortunate didn't fall for them.
Here's Flannery released by Milivojevic. Goes to ground, but a wonderful challenge in the box from Ashley Irwin. That is a fantastic covering tackle from the 23-year-old.
What a tackle. The way she's just lined up Flannery and come out and just defended her box like that. It just looks like she's been in this league for years.
That is inch perfect from Irwin. Oh, Milivojevic will deliver the resulting corner. Headed away, just about. Cameron Clough thought that she might have been able to get something on it. Badawiya in transition now. It's got players ahead of her. She'll look to play in Trimis, but cut out well by Clough. Total shots at the moment still fairly low for both sides. Mariners on 7, Canberra on 4. You've got to get those shots up, Canberra. If you don't shoot, you don't score.
Absolutely, and I'm sure Negos Popovic will be looking at when a good time will be to bring Maria Rojas off the bench as well and just add a little bit of spark to this second half.
Of course, she's been injured, so maybe minutes are limited. Christofferson now with an opportunity, will look to play in at teammate Heyman to Flannery, who shoots. Taryn King deals with it just about. Canberra appealing for a penalty, not given though. They'll retain possession. Ilioski moving infield, and a player brought to ground. Christofferson has been taken down in the penalty area. Penalty not given, and the crowd, they are fired up at that decision.
Surely that's got to be a penalty there, the way she's made that run across that defender and the way she brings her down. It's obviously Isabella Libri sees it in a different light.
Well, the home fans here at McKellar Park not happy with that, because to the naked eye it looks fairly clear cut, but not given. Here come Canberra again though, searching for this equaliser. Grove was forced backwards and recycled possession from Clough. Ball delivered in out wide, looking for Ruby Nathan. Nathan has the time to line up across. And Milivojevic strike, cleared by Taryn King. Well, it looked for all money like that would be Canberra's equaliser right there, but the Mariners captain in the way.
Other than her getting her head on that, you just would have thought that that ball would have been in the back of the net for Canberra United.
Here they come again. Unrelenting pressure at the moment. Heyman, heavy touch. Galich will take it away for the Mariners. Well, how close was that for Canberra? Is that a moment that they may come to regret?
Time will tell, Taryn, but you talked about it in the first half. We spoke about momentum in games, and it just seems that this last little bit, Canberra United are starting to have a couple of cracks on goal and starting to build that momentum up as well, and something's got to come for them.
Ulioski, lovely touch, sends the defender to ground, plays to Christofferson, will take on Bryson. Christofferson trying to use her pace. Did the last touch come off Bryson? It did. We'll take a look at these replays, this penalty shout.
What a great little ball and a great run in behind there from Christofferson. That's got to be a penalty in my mind. She's got her body right behind her and taking her down to ground, and I'd be feeling really hard done by if I was Canberra United. Here again, you can see Ruby Nathan, plenty of time to get across into the box. The little fallback here and the strike for Milivojevic. Anyone would have been putting money that that ball goes into the back of the net.
Well, here's Milivojevic with a corner in swinging, headed away by Wardlow. It'll come back out to Milivojevic. Squares it to Stanage Floody. Dinked in for Michelle Heyman, who can't quite find her feet, but Flannery goes to ground. Well, Mariners can't get this away. Milivojevic now getting involved. And finally, Langman comes out and claims and says, that's enough. But another fantastic series of opportunities for Canberra.
A little bit scrappy there once they get into the box, but a great little ball in by Stanage Floody in there, and gets a bit scrappy in that moment. But again, it just goes to show that Canberra United have got a little bit more momentum now coming into these last 10, 15 minutes.
Bryson, played to Hayward, taken away though by Heyman. Milivojevic, Christofferson. She'll look to switch play, but can't find and teammate. Ulioski searching for Milivojevic. Well intercepted by Hayward Lowe. Milivojevic. Can she get away from her defender this time? She goes to ground. And a foul given. Well, the double change now for Negos Popovic. Devin Jackson coming on, but also the Chilean international Maria Rojas makes her return from injury. Stanage Floody making way. And also Nikki Flannery as well. Well, this is a big occasion for Canberra because Rojas, the 36-year-old, she can be so influential. She's a real technician. Maybe lost some of her pace over the years, Knowles, but every team that she's played for in this competition, she's made a big difference to.
She does. She makes a massive difference to any team that she's part of. She's just got something different. She's very creative, especially when she gets into that front third area. And we know that she can make something from nothing. And to bring on a player at this point in the game is very, very important for Canberra United because they need to get something out of this game.
Here goes Clark with the free kick. Well, Rojas immediately involved in the action, but was well defended in the end by the Mariners. Ruby Nathan looking to find her countrywoman, Jackson, not able to do so. Bevan Jackson, Kiwi international, one appearance for the national team. Rojas puts in a cross, but straight at Sarah Langman. And she'll be happy to eat up as many seconds as she can. Bryson turns away from Christofferson. Nice touch from Badawiya. Long diagonal, looking for Ergemal. But the flag is up against the Chinese international, and Canberra will take the free kick.
The official attendance for today's match at MacKellar Park is 1,285.
We'll take a look at this replay again. It does look offside from this angle.
It's definitely offside. Ergemal, as a striker, you've got to do better in that position. You're watching the line. You're in that line of fire. You can see what's happening. You've just got to hold your run just that little bit longer. So that ball from Badawiya was actually a great little ball in behind.
Well, here goes Ergemal now. Finds the ball out wide, looking to get past Clark. Does well. No one at the back post, though. Peter Trimis has the ball taken away from her by Grove. Young Matilda's teammates, of course, those two. Jackson out to Christofferson. Plays in Milivojevic. There's always two or three Mariners defenders on Milivojevic as soon as she gets the ball. Nathan to Rojas. Maria Rojas. The ball goes out of play in Canberra. They'll win a corner.
I'm sure Emily Husband would have been talking a lot about Milivojevic and what impact she has on this Canberra United team. And definitely looking at ways that they can try to break her down and try and shut her down once in the matches. But it's a great little impact that we've seen from Maria Rojas already. She's eager to get back on the ball. I know, speaking to her a couple of weeks ago, she was battling with injury, and to get her back on the pitch and seeing her on the pitch today is fantastic for her.
Milivojevic, we've seen the corner, headed away by Taryn King. Sasha Grove picks up the second phase play, but her ball not where she wanted it to go. And Izzy Gomez will have the chance to play a through ball to Ergemal. Now, does she have options? Ergemal will look to square it, a touch in the favour of Badawiya. And Cannon Clough is there to clear. Frustrated Cannon Clough, because the Mariners, for a moment, were away.
They were away, and they've broken really well in that instance. Again, it comes off that second phase play. You can see Sasha Grove. You always know off corners, especially in that second phase, you just got to put that ball back into those dangerous areas. You don't want to play around with it because it catches you on that counter attack. And Canberra United were fortunate that they didn't get punished in that situation.
Well, cornery team Bryson. Another shot very, very high. Rice Mile. And she runs away. Not quite the direction that she would have liked. She has scored this season, Faye Bryson. But it's probably not showing off the best of her shooting abilities.
It's a difficult angle as well, the way that ball gets brought in, to be able to wrap your body around that, to be able to get something on target in that situation as well.
Well, now we're approaching the 70th minute of this game. Mariners still with that one goal lead, but Canberra threatening, and they'll have that home crowd behind them. As the ball is looking for Ergemal. Ergemal to double the Mariners' lead. She'll round the keeper, and she'll make it two. Wonderful from Ergemal. The Central Coast Mariners have their second. And isn't she thrilled about that?
She sure is. You can see the excitement on her face once she's put that ball in the back of the net. She's done really, really well in that situation. She's taken a little touch around Cannon Clough there. She's composed here in this area. She takes a touch around, left foot, straight in the back of the net. What a great finish by Ergemal.
That is so composed by Ergamal. Just one touch around Mostorovic, and of course Mostorovic would have in mind what happened to her teammate Chloe Lincoln last week when she rushed out to try and save a goal, took a touch, got the red card on that occasion. Ergamal able to get around her and put the ball in the back of the net.
Great finish by Ergamal, and again we talk about strikers and putting the ball in the back of the net and the confidence that it gives, and I'm sure that's going to give Ergamal and the Central Coast Mariners a lot more confidence in finishing off this game, because you could see, especially in this last 10-15 minutes, that Canberra United was starting to get more momentum and sitting at that 1-0 scoreline, and even now at this 2-0 scoreline, this game is not over yet.
It certainly is not. Home crowd behind them. Canberra United know how to score a goal. Pre-game, the team with the most goals scored per game in the competition. They've certainly got goals in them. Ilioski to Michelle Heyman. But now the Mariners with another chance to break. Wonderful run by Peter Trimmis. And ball taken away from her by Sasha Grove. We speak about moments. Well, Ergamal, of course, her first half goal, absolutely wonderful. And then she's had the opportunity one-on-one with the keeper. And she scored, and that's what you ask of your strikers in those situations.
That's exactly what you want from your strikers. You want to know that once they do get in that situation, they do have those moments. And as a striker, sometimes you might only get one or two moments, and you've got to make the most of it. And I think she's done fantastic with the moments that she has had, and she's delivered today.
Well, the shot from distance on that occasion from Izzy Gomez. Wanted to get in on the action, but wide of the post. Well, Canberra now, they'll take a few more risks. They'll really look to drive forward and create the opportunities that they need. Here's Grove. Ball looking for Rojas, but goes beyond her. Rojas just not able to get the possession that she wants to fashion an opportunity. But they'll have a throw in high up the pitch. Rojas against Taryn King. Wardlow coming to help out as well. It'll be Nathan. Well dealt with by Devon Jackson. Back out to Grove. Sasha Grove still going. She'll whip in a ball. Cleared away just. Rojas goes to ground, but again, nothing doing from the referee. And Ergamal is in space again. She has the opportunity to score a hat-trick, Ergamal. Well, she went first time. She calculated that Clark was about to catch up with her and just skewed her effort wide.
You could see exactly what she was lining up for. She was looking for that chip to be able to chip that keeper again. And you could see the way the ball was just running away from her. She didn't get that exact touches that she wanted to on that ball. But Mariners have done really well there. What a great ball in behind as well. And again, this ball just run away from her, but you can see the way she's trying to get her body around it. She knew that she was done for pace there in terms of taking an extra touch, but she's done super well in that position.
Bryson, ball in, and to be headed away by Grove. Lioski helping on to Clark, but her touch too heavy, and out for a Mariners throw. Here comes Jackson. She'll play it back from Rojas. Canberra trying to play the ball out of trouble, trying to do the right thing in possession, but they're being done by these balls through by the Mariners at the moment. Heyman to Rojas. Rojas can't get away from Galich. Bianca Galich, wonderful ball through to Peter Trimmis. She's got Izzy Gomez. If she can find her, Trimmis, she'll go herself. Peter Trimmis with her first goal in the Liberty A-League. She all but seals the game now for the Central Coast Mariners. A wonderful goal for the 17-year-old.
What a fantastic finish by Peter Trimmis. The young Matilda, she's done super well in that situation. The way she takes her touch back on her right foot, even his first touch, as she takes a touch across her body here to get him into the box and set herself up. And the way she's just put that in the back of the net is just absolute world class.
Well, what a moment for the young Matilda. Her first goal in the competition after scoring 10 for Bulls Academy in the NPL New South Wales. Wonderful, wonderful memory for her. And it makes it 3-0 now for the Mariners.
You would say that this game is pretty much signed, sealed, delivered now, but fantastic. We've got to talk about Peter Trimmis and all these young Matildas that are playing across this Liberty A-League and how fantastic it is for our game, and to see, you know, a lot of these young girls getting these opportunities to be able to play decent minutes is fantastic for their development as well.
Ergamal out wide will deliver a ball in, dangerous again, and now a shot from Galich. Had to be saved by Mistrovic. The Mariners are all over Canberra at the moment.
Canberra United looking super shaky at this point, and it's really important that they group together and really stay disciplined, because you don't want to have a blowout in scoreline, because it wouldn't be a true reflection of where this game is at today. And I think it's important that they stay disciplined and really work on still trying to move that ball forward and trying to create some more opportunities.
Well, it's going to be difficult for Canberra to get back. You felt it 1-0, at 2-0. That was certainly in the game. 3, it's a huge scoreline to overcome in the last 15 minutes. But with players like Michelle Heyman, with Vesna Milivojevic, you know that they're going to give it a crack. Here's Ilioski. Has to play it back to Clark. It's from these positions that they're going to find very difficult, because the Mariners, they'll sit in those deep blocks and they'll make it very difficult to be broken down.
We all know defensively that Central Coast Mariners, that's been one of their strengths this season.
Well, Jackson tried to take a strike from outside the area. Here's Rojas driving into the area. Can't beat Langman. She's so technically gifted, Rojas. 11 goals for Chile in her career. She was the first Chilean to ply her trade overseas in a professional sense. A legend of world football, really, at 36 years of age. She's still got a lot left in her, but couldn't quite make that count for her side on that occasion. Here's Badawiya, lovely touch roll of Badawiya, goes to ground and wins the free kick. Milivojevic, too much of a heavy touch on Badawiya, as adjudged by the referee, Isabella Libri. Well, you can see in the expression of Milivojevic, she's furious at having given that foul away.
Yeah, you can just see, we know that Milivojevic is a winner. She's got that mentality, that winning mentality. She wouldn't be happy knowing where the team is sitting right now, you know, being down by 3 goals, and she'll do anything for her team to win. You can just see in her face the frustrations as well.
Well, it'll be Faye Bryson and Bianchi Galich standing over this free kick. Galich will play in. Bryson squares it and had to be dealt with by Canberra. Second phase play now, but cleared away. An opportunity on the counter, but Rojas had touched too heavy. Although it'll be called back for a foul. It happened earlier in the play.
Double substitution for Canberra United coming off the field is number 3, Sarah Clark.
So that'll be the end of the starting debut of Sarah Clark. Tegan Bertolicio and Alex McKenzie will come on the pitch. And Emma Ilioski also making way. Well, that's interesting, because that's two defensive substitutions. Alex McKenzie and Tegan Bertolicio, both centre-backs.
Yeah, super interesting. You can see as well, obviously, Sarah Clark, it could be a case of limited minutes as well. We've seen her come off the bench last week, and maybe a little bit more of increased minutes this week. Or is he looking at already planning towards next week and sort of putting this game on the back burner?
I mean, substitutions like that, is that damage control? Although Canberra still trying to make a play at it. Heyman was driving forward, but to me, Kath, those substitutes are not necessarily positive ones.
Look, at 3-0, it's always a tough one, but unfortunately he looks to his bench and he's got Alex McKenzie and Tegan Bertolicio left, and if you just want to freshen up for the last, you know, 10 or so minutes, just to make sure that, again, that the floodgates don't open, and you don't want to go into that next week and have a heavy loss, because we always know it's very hard for a team to pick themselves up in that situation.
Heyman plays it back to Ruby Nathan. Was able to keep possession. Well, they'll play it all the way back. Now to Cannon Clough. They'll play a long diagonal. And cleared away by the Mariners defence. Bertolicio throw in. Madawea getting back and doing her defensive duties. The forward. Christofferson now gets past Badawea. Can't get past Bryson. Milivojevic. Can she create something to make a game of it? Haywood defends well, and the Mariners come away with it. Although Ergamal, heavy touch, gives Devon Jackson the opportunity to get on the ball. And now ball delivered in for Canberra. Bodies in the box. Rojas got a hand on it. Just didn't have the power to beat Langman. And Bryson is down. What looks like perhaps a head knock. We'll have to see on the replay.
Could possibly have been a, once they've both come up for that header.
It looks like she's just motioning at her cheekbones, so maybe something of that nature. The crowd not happy. They're claiming it's time wasting.
They never are in Canberra, but we also know she had that earlier knock in the first half as well, so she could be feeling a little bit of that as well. So that second knock.
Well, we're seeing a double change now for the Mariners. Let's see Kari Stoll coming on the pitch. As is Tiana Karambassis. Rumba Badawea, one of the substitutes, making way.
And coming off the field is Faye Bryson.
As is Faye Bryson, who was just the victim of that knock just before. So maybe managing of minutes from Emily Husband.
Of course, when you're in this position, you're 3-0 up. Not long to go. You can start to rest players. You can start to give your players on the bench some minutes as well, and start getting them involved in the game as well. That's always the toughest part of a coach or of a manager of any team, is how do you manage players? How do you get minutes into your players? How do you keep them all in a position where they're always committed to the team and they're wanting to strive for more?
Here's Alex McKenzie, the substitute. Maybe showing why she was substituted on, showing some pretty quick feet out of centre back, but it's the Mariners who come away with it regardless. Gjallic looking to play that through ball. They've done that so well today, the Mariners. Rasmussen over the top, was looking for Gomez, just got away from her. But a neat ball from Rasmussen, substituted on earlier as well, the academy product.
Young Central Coast local, which is fantastic to see that she's come through the Central Coast Mariners Academy as well. And to be able to have a local homegrown player, I'm sure over these next few years, they'll be looking to start to introduce a lot more of them as well.
And Haywood going to ground. Well, there's a good crowd out in Canberra, just under 2,000. Considering as well, so many Canberrans away for the holiday period. They go to the south coast. We'll just take a look at this foul again by Bernalicio.
Tough tackle there on Haywood. Going back to the crowd and to see so many people getting behind this Liberty A-League. Crowds are being up across the whole league, which is fantastic to see. It's just such a great spectacle to be able to go out, these young families, to see not only for Matildas that are in this Liberty A-League, but also all the up-and-coming young Matildas and the fantastic product of the Liberty A-League.
Ball in by the Mariners. Ergamal looking for her hat-trick. Still trying to find her feet, Ergamal. Rojas searching for the run of Heyman. Wasn't able to find it. And played out to Irwin. Is not able to keep the ball in, so Canberra trying to play the ball up the line. They're just not able to break down the Mariners at the moment. And now here's the pace of the youngster, Peter Trimis. Couldn't get there in time. Player down now with what looks like cramp. The crowd aren't too happy about it, but play won't stop. Play only stops if there's a head injury. Otherwise, play will continue unless the prone player is interfering. So here's Christofferson. Pull the ball off early and out for a throw. Play will stop because it's Ergamal who's down. Kathleen certainly do hurt.
That is not a great position to be in. That is one of the worst feelings in the world, being on the pitch and cramping. And obviously the heat and the pitches are probably playing a part in her cramping. But she's done a lot of work this game as well, which is credit to her.
Well, apologies, we did misspeak earlier because Rasmussen is just entering the field of play now, the local academy product. Always good to big up academy products regardless, probably giving her a bit too much credit though. Here's Milivojevic with the corner in. McKenzie looking to deliver something. And here's Rojas. Can she find a teammate? We'll square it just into the side netting. Another opportunity repelled by the Mariners.
It's a great little 1-2 in there to get Rojas in behind. And again, she just couldn't cut that ball back just in time. But the way she drops it and she goes and gets herself in a dangerous area there, it's just unfortunate that she couldn't cut that ball back a little bit more.
Langman now just kicking for distance. Here is Rasmussen. Mariners in possession. Taryn King. Gjallich now up the line. Alexia Karras-Stahl not able to keep it in. So it'll be out for a Canberra throw. Here come the Mariners. Rasmussen goes to ground just outside the penalty area. Cannon Clough Well, she's mistimed her challenge on that occasion. And the Mariners with another chance from a set piece.
In that position there, you just got to stay on your feet. They're not in a dangerous position. She's going towards the sideline, so you just got to make sure that you just sort of guide her in that way, and you don't have to jump in there in that position.
And just that mistimed challenge from the American defender.
You would think a bit of frustration as well from Cannon Clough. It's been a tough afternoon.
Oh, short free kick and a shot from just on the edge of the area. Not enough power on it, though. But a training ground routine from the Mariners. Milivojevic. Well, she's gone to ground in a bit of pain here, but advantage will be played. And the Mariners have come away with the ball. And she's back up on her feet. Bertolicio in possession. Looking to play it to Rojas. Back to Bertolicio and out for a Mariners throw. Well, Canberra United, they've got 5 minutes to pull off what would be something spectacular, but at the moment, it doesn't look like the afternoon is going their way as the yellow card shown to Isabel Gomez from that earlier challenge.
It was a bit of a tough challenge there on Vesna Milivojevic. She just clipped there from behind.
And there is Milivojevic trying to make something happen. She's had magic in her boots this season, Milivojevic. That yellow card, in fact, earlier was for time wasting by Gomez. So referee making sure that things are happening at a faster clip.
I don't think you really need to time waste with only 5 minutes on the stoppage clock and you're up 3-0. It's a bit of a wasteful yellow card, to be honest.
And here comes Rasmussen, but the offside flag is raised, so Canberra will win back possession. Gallage playing it back. And possession lost by Ash Irwin. Vesna Milivojevic. Can she give Canberra hope? Squares it to Rojas. Back to Milivojevic, who's brought to ground. But the referee does not award the penalty. Well, Canberra United cannot believe it. Nothing has gone their way in this game. That's just another example.
Absolutely. We talk about having a little bit of luck on your side when you're playing this beautiful game of football, and it's been unfortunate that not much has fallen for Canberra United this afternoon.
Well, there was that very credible penalty shout earlier in the game, and now another one. They count as well for Sophia Christofferson. Apologies, it was number 6, Isabel Gomez, so he's just come up with the wrong number on our graphics. Apologies for that one. Well, there's the penalty shout again.
She's definitely put her body there, and Besson's trying to get something on it, and the referee sees it in a different light.
Alex McKenzie waiting to take this free kick for Canberra. She'll play it out wide, but touch just letting her down for Christofferson. Can't get past Irwin. Nice little touch on the inside by Jackson. Devon Jackson will shoot from distance. Ambitious. And over the crossbar. Well, next week for Canberra United, they play Western United at home, Saturday, 30th of December. That'll be a very important game for them because unless they can pull something out in the next minute, minute and a half, this will be now two games in a row that they haven't scored. And if Canberra United have done anything this season, it's score goals. So some worrying signs for Negros Popovic and his side.
It does. It becomes really tough for the team to try and pick themselves up and go again. And look, they've won one in the last six games, which is sometimes a tough ask to come back from. But it's not going to be an easy game for them next week against Western United. Every game in this Liberty A-League is a tough game. There's no game that you turn up to and you know that you're going to pick up 3 points.
Ball finds Irwin, although she loses out. Heyman was lurking, couldn't get the appropriate touch. Now Gomez, a heavy touch, but wins out anyway. Rasmussen to Galich. Isabel Gomez. I'll look to just wind down the clock now. The Mariners. Happy to just keep possession because it is now full time in Canberra. The Central Coast Mariners decisive 3-0 victors. A brace to Ergamal and a first ever A-League women's goal to 17-year-old Peter Trimmis. They were the dominant side in the second half despite some chances to Canberra United. So at full time, it's Canberra United 0, Central Coast Mariners 3. Well, we'll take a look at the highlights and it'll show that whilst Canberra did have their chances, it became relatively one-sided by the end.
It did in the end. We could see Central Coast Mariners really in the first half with Ergamal here. You can see that she attacks this space in front of her and takes a strike. And again, no goalkeepers getting to that ball. It was a fantastic strike by Ergamal.
And that set the tone because the first half was so even. But then in the second, the Mariners really asserted themselves.
They did. You know, this Canberra United team came out in the second half. They'd done quite well. They had a few chances, and then Ergamal comes out with this. She takes a touch here around her defender. She squares the goalkeeper up here, takes a touch around the goalkeeper, and a great, easy finish into the back of the net.
And those one-on-ones, they're certainly not as easy as they look, are they?
They aren't. You get into these positions, and anything can happen. And she knows exactly what she's doing as she's coming around. And the best thing about Ergamal that she can put the ball in the back of the net with her left or her right foot. She's technically so gifted.
And then how about this? Bianca Galich wins out and plays through Peter Trimmis, the 17-year-old, her first ever A-League women's goal.
Fantastic weighted ball there by Bianca Galich. She knows exactly what she's doing. She picks up the ball. She gets Peter Trimmis in behind. Perfectly weighted ball. Peter Trimmis has done fantastic. She takes her touch into the box. She sets herself up with a second touch and puts a third touch into the back of the net. And a great finish by Peter Trimmis.
Well, that's a moment that she will remember for a long time, no doubt. Well, here are the stats. Canberra United actually ending up with more possession and more shots in the end, which doesn't really pass the eye test of what we saw on the pitch.
I think in the end, Central Coast Mariners really ran away with it, especially once they got that second goal. But you can't take any credit away from Canberra United. They did create chances of just about being a little bit more clinical once they did get in that final third. We could see with Canberra United as well, once they did concede that second and third goal, that they just sort of fell away a little bit. But credit to Central Coast Mariners, they put the ball in the back of the net this afternoon and come away with the 3 points.
Well, thank you so much for joining us on this broadcast this afternoon. It's been a pleasure. My name is Taryn Hennell. I was joined by Catherine Canulli. Have a very Merry Christmas, however you're celebrating, and goodbye.